If it wasn't for God's breath in me, I would be nothing. My own breath is worthless. Without him, I am powerless. My heritage was with those born of low stature, and God has raised me to be born of high stature, but not like those that think they are, but are alive. You weigh nothing. You are of no value. Everything you have has been gained by deceit, with lies and extortion. You have stolen the hearts of men. What you trust in, what you take pride in, what you have set your heart on are all lies, all of them. Only trusting in Jesus will you gain honor and receive the priceless reward of salvation. I render unto you the punishment you deserve if you have not done what you're supposed to. All works must come from faith in Jesus Christ to count for anything. The problem is that a lot of people do things, but how many really do what they do because it's the Christian thing to do? Hardly none. Most people do only when asked or pestered, and then usually only if it's a friend. From now on, if you wish to remain a sheep, you must not act like a goat. If a brother in Christ is in need, you must help them. If you tell them no, it's like telling me no, and you will be punished. To be judged according to your works is if you do good works or bad works. Coming against me in war is not renouncing yourself. Our sin brought Jesus' death. You have not made a Christian following all Christ taught, but all you taught. This book is not only to declare to all who I am, but to clarify a few doctrines taught by denominations. The scriptures are intended to be used to bring people to faith in Christ and belief in God the Father and Creator of all. A lot of people just want to use them to bring moral conformity to society. Just trying to use religion to control people is wrong and denies its true power. The gates of hell cannot prevail against true faith. What religion did Jesus practice? His coming did not replace it with a new true religion. We're supposed to be practicing Judaism with Jesus as the Messiah. God is the author. I bring the field of battle into the mind and soul of every man, woman, and child on this planet. This is the day we have been working for. God is my Father, but it doesn't mean I am equal. He gives and he can take away. But in this case, he has given me all power and authority. God does love me. I am doing the greatest and most amazing thing ever. I speak and the dead are raised. I am judging all, and I am the one who chooses what stays in this life and what doesn't. God has given me some of the honor that is usually only for him. God has done all this for me because I do this to please him. Everything you see me do is the same that God would do because he is the one doing it. God has allowed me to judge all because he knows I'll judge righteously. I am not going to judge to please anyone else, and I can't be bribed. It's all based on whether you have done good or evil. If you don't honor my judgment, you don't honor my Father. People probably thought Jesus was delusional when he spoke also. If you're waiting for God to come and judge you, you will be waiting a long time, and I will condemn you with the evil. All are going to rise up and be judged. The martyrs were raised first because they did bear their cross to the point of losing their life. They don't require me to show them mercy, but the rest are being judged according to what is written in this book, just like you are. This is an eternal judgment, and it applies to those that will be born in the future also. To cross a Jordan is to cross from death to life. If you accept what I say is the truth and is from God, then you will have eternal life. And if you know what I say have spoken is because I am the Son of God, then I'll allow you to live in the kingdom of God. This is the time for all those that are spiritually dead to get a chance to live. No denomination is going to set the rules on how people are to be judged. You could have crossed over at any time if you had heard Christ's voice and lived, but my voice is so loud that even the dead in their graves can hear it. I tell you the truth, this is the time of judgment. Just as what my Father says will give you life, he has allowed what I say to give you life, because I am no longer a son of man, but a son of God with all the authority that the Father can bestow upon a son. Come out of all of you who are in the grave and meet your Savior. Only I can save you from eternal death. All will be judged with mercy, except those who have been judging others without mercy. They will be judged the way they judge. If you never forgive others, why should you be forgiven? Since God had to show me mercy, he is going to show you mercy. Blow the trumpet and shout for joy because of the freedom mercy gives. I rule and judge by the law that gives you freedom. You're free to stay in the kingdom if you are good, and you're free to leave if you won't be good. Mercy first, judgment second. I judge on whether I should show you mercy or not, which is based mostly on whether you are merciful and repentful. It is I who bring forth the spiritually dead by Allah's leave. The Bible is not tainted by human error, and neither is what I am saying. Both Jesus and Muhammad and even Moses have been perfect model for mankind, and so am I, since I also am the very Word of God dwelling among us. However, the message I give which supersedes the message given in the Quran, New Testament, and even the Torah, is the permanent message for us to follow, because it makes us all into perfect model, a model that is in the image and likeness of God, because it makes us all His children. Of course, I want you to continue to have faith in Jesus as unique among all, even though I also want you to have faith of Jesus by believing you are also a son of God.